I'm sick for nothing but to be charming.
What?
Under the cover of me.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Being around me does not help you to preserve.
Thank you.
That's right.
If it does not encourage you, amen, to preserve what he gives you. Because not only does salt create a thirst, hallelujah, it also serves as an agent for preserving. Now, you young folk don't know that, but this father here, and she know it. Amen, praise God. And some of the other people know that we used to preserve with salt when you put meat in the bone. Yeah, I'm for that school too. When you saw it, the ham down, hung it up in the bone until it cured. Let the church say amen. And so, Ella Hodges, they told me if I put enough salt there, it'll cure some stuff. Let the church say amen. My God, in my day, even if you had a splinter in your finger, they put some a piece of fat that you need on it, put some salt and wrap it up, it'll grow out. God ain't stopping to me. Let the church say amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So salt is good for me. Let the church say amen. Because salt preserves my going out and my coming in. Let the church say amen. And so he uses salt and light. Let the church say amen. And so when you see some unique woman who possesses a superior quality in a specific area, she desires to discover what makes that woman different. Let the church say amen. Amen. It is also possible that salt, as I've already said, amen, preserves you against the evil of this society. Let the church say amen. And Pastor, I was studying in one of my textbooks last night. It called Encountering the Book of Romans. Amen. In the seventh chapter of Romans. And then Paul talks about, amen, the realm of transferring. Let the church say amen. He says, amen, Elijah, that when I got saved, I was transferred. Out of the Adamic realm into the Christ realm. Let the church say amen. And even though sin, amen, has not been fully eradicated from my surroundings, because I got salt, it preserves me in the midst of evil. Let the church say amen. And I told God the other day, when I was talking with him, glory to God, I said, Lord, I need a peer tutor. I need somebody to tutor me in the fine arts of the word. Let the church say amen. I need somebody to tell me every now and then, all about, don't you go in this direction. Don't go in that way. Even though I know it, but sometimes I need to be reminded. Because of flesh, I need to be reminded that the steps of a good man are far from the Lord. I need to be reminded that even though I the salvation of the Lord. I stop by to tell the ladies, it matters. Oh, how I look. Let the church say amen. The Lord is coming on us to help build the kingdom. He's coming on us to help bring these young girls into the kingdom. Let the church say amen.
If it fails to be salty, he has lost his purpose for existence and should be discarded. A light is meant to give direction. Help me somebody. Glory to God. Individuals that Jesus is describing should radiate and point other women to the proper path. Women out in force will be evident. It will be like a city. Amen. On a hill, a lamp on a lampstand. And where they think they got you hid. Hallelujah. Amen. When you even finally come into where God has called you to be, you do understand that the enemy is on his course.